Hello friends, so today we will discuss how to create class we will discuss how to create a class in Python and how to create constructor or how to define the constructor in Python. So we will discuss both these topics one by one. So first you have to understand what is class. So basically, we will say a class is like a prototype, or you can say a model, in which you will define which data members belongs to this class and which member functions belongs to this class. So basically, I have written here, let's suppose if you want to have a building, you have a prototype of it. You can define here the number of the windows, floor, doors. There are the number of the things that you can set in each and every class according to your requirement. So that means the data members will become the properties of that class. And how to have these members to be assessed and how to manipulate it, this is our main task. So I just want to give you the idea. The class is basically like a place where you have defined which data members you are going to use and which member functions or which functions you are going to use for this particular class. And these members are easily accessible, and there is a mechanism to assess the functions of that particular class or the data members of that particular class. Now, the one more concept that you have to understand, class is just a virtual entity. Virtual entity means it doesn't have any existence in reality. It is just like a blueprint. Now, it is a virtual form, so that means how it will come into existence then. The second concept that leads to us to make it existable, we have to define or we have to create the object of that class. That is also known as the instance of a class. Until or unless we will create an object of a class, you can't assess the data members or the member functions of that class. So I am showing you here. To create class, first you have to define the keyword class, then write your class name. This is user defined. You can write name here according to your choice. Then you have to specify the colon to indicate the block of your class gets started. Now this is my data member. So because I have used here a variable. Now, how to use this particular class? This is I had already told you. Until or unless you will create a class, you can't assess the data member or a member function of it. So I have called here an object, the class with the indication of my, because my class name is my, and I have specified here in the form of the functionality. Here I have defined the object p. Now this is the instance creation. By default, I hadn't used any constructor here till now. So by default, our default constructor will work, and I can assess the properties or the data members or the member functions by using the dot operator. So that is object name dot and then data member or a member function that you want to assess. So you can see here, I have printed here just x variable, but this is possible only with the help of the object. Now the next thing that I want to tell you, that let's suppose you have these three particular data members and you have defined a function here. As earlier told in the earlier videos, to define the function you have to use the keyword def, that is def. Now self it just indicates the instance of a particular class or an instance of the current class to which it is defined. So now my display is defined in the employee. So self means it is referring to its own class even. So I am getting its attribute with the help of dot operator. So that is self. So that means on class ID and on class name and age or any other attribute that you want to assess. Now I have defined it here. Now how to use it? I have called the class by creating the emp just. So on creating the object of that particular class, our object or a class has come into existence, and then these items will be get printed there. Now next thing, as I had told you, till now we haven't defined any constructor. By default, constructor works. Constructor means to create something. To create means to give the memory to our data members or the member functions of the class. This is not possible until and unless there is a constructor. So if you haven't defined your own constructor, The interpreter will call a default constructor that will create your object. So create your object means each and number of objects can be created, because as I had already told you, there is a model of the building, but you can have your own choice of the attributes, that is how many doors it will have, how many rooms it will have. So that is all depends on you. So if there is a class, you can create any number of objects of that particular class. Now if you have defined your own constructor, then the default constructor will not work, the your user defined constructor can work here. There are the two types of the constructors, that is parameterized and non-parameterized. Now parameterized, as I had already told you, parameters means arguments. So you will supply the argument. In non-parameterized, you will not supply any argument. Now one more thing, the constructor definition is executed when we create the object. So that means as soon as the object is created, object will be created only if there is a constructor. If you haven't defined, then the default will work. Now how to define the constructor in Python? So you have to define the method with the keyword, that is init. Init means initiate. So you have to indicate this. There is an underscore in the front and the back. This is just the indication that our constructor is now going to create, and this is very important, as you can define your own constructor according to your choice. Now I have defined here class with the class name person. You can see here I have first defined the constructor. So constructor has, I have defined here, first you have to indicate to which object it belongs. So self means it indicates that the constructor belongs to its own class only. Then the name and age and salary. Now these three attributes should be initialized, as init itself indicates that initialized. So you can see here I have defined here an object. As soon as I will create the object with these parameters, these name, age and salary will get value. So this is used to initialize the variables that belongs to a particular class. So you can print it by using the object name dot data member. Now I have used your self parameter. This is just to indicate that it belongs to its own class. This is not compulsory. You can have your own name also, and you have to use it according to your choice. So mine. So mine indicates that this is indicating that this belongs to this particular class, and I am assessing it by using the mine. So there is no compulsion that you have to define the self keyword. Now the next thing, that is how to modify the object properties. Now in the last example, I have defined here the name and age. Now if you want to change some attributes value, you can redefine it by using the object name dot attribute name and set it to the new value. Now when you can see here in the previous, that is name age, and you have seen here that is 36. Now my age 36 is, now I have set from 36 to 40. If I again call the function my FUNC, that is my function, and I am again printing it, it is now 40, it is now not 36, because it has initialized to this value, but I have overwritten it, or we had set it to this. So this is how to modify the object property. You have to specify the object name dot attribute name that you want to, or a property name which you want to reset again. Now the two programs that I want to discuss with you, that is how to have the particular number of objects to be deal with. So let's see, I have defined here class, then I have defined the constructor, and I am going to initialize these two attributes or properties. You can say I have to supply the values at the time of the object creation, as you can see. So you name first, for the first object it is John, and ID is this, and for the second object is this. Now you can see here in the display function, as this is a string, so to have the accessibility of the ID and the name, we have to format it to the string type, that is already indicated, that is known as a format operator, that is discussed in the previous video. And then you can display, you can call the display function for each and every object as they have their own attributes. So this is how to deal with the multiple objects. Now the next thing, the program is here, that is how to count the students. So let's suppose I have defined here a count, so that is my data member, and I have defined here the constructor. Since there is no supply of the any value, there is just the calculation of the value, that is student.count plus 1, because it has already initialized there. So if you will call the number of the times, it will be incremented by 1 by 1, and you can print here that is student.count. As you can see here, that is this particular class and the attribute can be accessible in this way. So student.count is initialized, that is for the one then for the second it is 2, and then for the 3, then after that if you will print the count value, it has the 3 value. Now, as I had already told you in this lecture, that there is two types of the constructor, that is either the parameterized or the non-parameterized. So first we will discuss the non-parameterized. So you can see here I have defined here class and I have just here written self. So there is no supply of any value. So you can see here I have defined here show function to have the name printed here. So as soon as I will create a object of this student class, and I have to call this particular function show to get our name. But in a parameterized constructor, I am supplying the name value at the time of the object creation, and this object creation is indicated in the name itself, that is self.name is equal to name, and in the show you can have this without any attribute passage of the name, because that is already passed in the constructor. So that is a parameterized constructor, but still you are able to access it. So after calling the show, you can see here. Now the next thing that I want to show you, there are some inbuilt class functions. So this is just to get attribute, some attribute if you want to assess, if you want to set any particular value to the attribute to a new value, if you want to delete some attribute, and if you want to check if whether this particular attribute exists or not, so has attribute. So I'm just going to show you, there is the class creation, and then I have defined the constructor with attribute name, ID and age, and at the time of object creation I have supplied these value. If I want to assess the particular attribute, so that is get attribute of each object, S object, which attribute I want to assess, that is name. So you can see here there is the name printing. Similarly, I have set the attribute of object S to value 23. If I will now again want to print it, so that is indication of 23. Print get attribute 23, it will be there. Now next attribute we are going to use, that is has attribute. So as this attribute exists in our class, so this is true value. Now after deleting, if we want to print the age attribute, it will give us the error. Now there are some attributes that you can also check, that is dictionary. It indicates the information about the class namespace, and for the document it belongs to, if you want to assess the class name, if you want to assess a particular module in the class, and if you want to have a tuple that includes all the base class of any particular class. So you can see here I have defined here class, then I have defined here function, that is constructor, with the three attributes, and at the time of the object creation I have passed these attributes, and in the function display detail I have printed this particular value. I want to assess it by using the print function. Now the next thing that I want to assess, that is, you can see here this is my attributes values in the form of tuple that already exists. So you can see here, that is, it belongs to the main module, and dictionary is that indicates that this particular, and it hasn't any particular document, it doesn't belong to any particular document. I haven't specified it in a particular file. So you can see here that there is a none value. Thank you.